A new playground for you. It's the HashiStack playground. Let's dig in and see how to use this one. So in your TeKanAid account, you can go to all products, and I've already added it to the DevOps playgrounds bundles. But if you're new, you have to first sign up for a TeKanAid account, and from here you can access the free DevOps playground bundle. And you can see we have five playgrounds in here. And once you have enrolled in this DevOps playgrounds bundle, all the playgrounds will show up like you see on the screen. So our HashiStack playground is a topic of today's video. So you can go in here and you can start the lesson. And in here it will show you where to access the playground. And again, it's running in GitHub's code spaces. So all you need to do is click this button. But before we do that, just know that you need to have a GitHub account. And these are the tools that are going to get access to within this playground. So we have Packer, Terraform, Vault, Consul, Nomad, Boundary, Waypoint, Sentinel. I also have Terraform Docs, TerraGrunt, TFLint, the Terraform Language Server, as well as Ansible and Docker. Now I have Vault, Consul, Nomad, Boundary, and Waypoint will automatically launch as dev servers for you. You can leverage that right away. And also go to the ports tab to access the UI of each one of these tools. So as you can see, these are all the HashiCorp tools, and I've added a few more tools as well in case you might need them. All right, so click on the open in GitHub code spaces button, and everything should be set for you here, and just click create code space. This will launch a code space inside of GitHub. And if you're not familiar with Codespaces, it is an environment that runs in GitHub's cloud where you're going to get a Visual Studio Code window right in your browser. There's also going to be a terminal you can access. And you can do all kinds of development work in this environment. So you don't have to worry about running a development workstation on your computer and adding all these different tools that we just saw. All of that will get installed for you right away once you launch this code space. Now, the first time you launch this code space, it is going to take a little bit of time for everything to get launched and installed. Yeah, but once you've done that, that code space will run in your account. It has a timeout, I believe, of 30 minutes. And once you're inactive for 30 minutes, the code space will stop. It won't get deleted, so you can relaunch it whenever you need to, and it will go much, much faster when you relaunch it. Of course, based on the free tier that CodeHub Codespaces offers, it really depends on how frequent you can launch it and what limits you might run into. But for development purposes that I usually encounter, it's pretty generous. GitHub's Codespaces free tier is pretty generous in its offering. So I'm going to pause the video until this has completely launched, and then we'll come back and see how to use this playground. Okay, so this has launched already, and you can see that we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 terminal windows that have opened. Each one is named according to the tool that we're running. So we've got Consul, Vault, Nomad, Waypoint, and Boundary. If you click on Consul, you can see the logs for Consul as it's running. If we can scroll to the top, you can see how it started. And then we can see Vault. Vault is also running, and it's running on port 8200 as is usual. Here's the unsealed key and the root token. Nomad is also running as well. Waypoint is running also. And finally, Boundary is running. Now, we can go to the port section, and for some reason, sometimes Codespaces launches these auto-forward ports. So we can just delete those and leave the GitHub Codespaces ports. These are the ones that we're going to use. So let's just get rid of these ones. And you can now click on any one of these ports to go to the UI of the tool that you need. So the first one is Nomad. So if you click on this globe icon, this should open our browser window over to Nomad. And here is the Nomad, the Nomad UI, as we just saw. If we want to see Vault, that's the one on port 8200. So this will take us to the Vault UI. If we want to see Consul, which is this one, click here and this will open Consul for us. You can see that Consul has already registered the Nomad node here as a client and as a server. So we can go back here and this one is Boundary, port 9200. Click that. That will open up Boundary for you. And then finally, Waypoint. If you try to click this, sometimes you might get this client sent an HTTP request over an HTTPS server. So what you do is go here and right click and change the port visibility. Change the port protocol to HTTPS and then try again. And really I had to go back and forth a little bit, a couple of times between port visibility, between changing the port HTTP and HTTPS to get to the Waypoint UI. So not a big deal. Just change it back and forth a couple of times, and that should get it to work. And basically now we've got all these tools here. We can also check on other tools that are not running as servers. So we've got Terraform. You can see the Terraform version. You can see Packer version. You can see what else here? Sentinel. You can check on Sentinel here. We've got Terragrunt, Ansible, Docker. So a lot of tools that you can just run with here. I'm not sure what your use case might be, but it's a really neat playground where you can do quite a few things. And if you're curious to know how this was built, you can go to the dev container folder, and under devcontainer.json file, you'll see that we're running the image here that's provided by Microsoft and a few features that we've enabled. So Docker in Docker, that's how we get Docker right here. How we've got Terraform installed with Terragrunt, tfLint, and so on. We've got the Ansible latest version. Everything here is the latest version, by the way, when you run it. So you've got Boundary, Consul, Nomad, Packer, Sentinel, the Terraform language server, Vault, Waypoint, Terraform docs as well. And here are the ports that we're exposing or we're forwarding, so that we can access those different UIs for the different tools. And these are the post attach commands that we're running. As you can see, we're running everything in dev mode here, Consul, Vault, Nomad, Waypoint, and Boundary. And customizations, this is just for the extensions for Visual Studio Code. And we are requesting the resources, as you can see on the screen, 4 CPUs, 8 gigs of memory, and 32 gigs of storage. So that's pretty much it for this HashiStack playground. I hope you enjoyed this video. Take it for a spin. Let me know what you think in the comments section, if you are happy with this or if you need more tools in this playground. I would be happy to add a few more. Thank you very much, and I will see you in another video.